大家好，我是 Spark。 自从我发布了什么是 B2B 借贷的影片过后，网友就问了我一些问题，还有我本身也有一些疑问，所以我今天就亲自来到 Funding Study 的 office 来亲自去问他的 CEO。 So how can Funding Study generate such a high return which is more than 10%?
So funding societies do not generate the returns for investors. It is because investors invest into SMEs via funding societies platform. The SMEs who get the financing generates the return from running the business and passes it on back to the investors. So funding societies is just the middleman that helps to connect the investors who is investing into the SME and then the SMEs making the repayments to investors. So funding societies do not generate any returns to investors.
So actually it is the... You lend the investor, lend the SME money, then the SME pay them with interest.
Yes, correct. That's it. Correct.
Okay. So why would SME want to borrow through funding societies, which is the interest is so high?
So the for SMEs, they can either come to funding societies or to banks for financing, right? So the value proposition of how we differentiate ourselves from banks is basically we do not require collateral from the SME when it comes to applying for financing. Secondly, it's also we do the disbursement much quicker than banks. So we can disperse the funds to SMEs much quicker. So within a week upon approval, but if you look at banks, typically it might take 2 to 3 months. Mm. So lastly, when it comes to financing, we provide much shorter term financing to SMEs, 6 to 12 months, as compared to banks, which is 5 to 7 years. So even though the interest rate percentage is higher, the total dollar interest cost that you bear on the financing is actually a lot lower when it comes to funding societies.
Mm, okay. So default risk is a major risk in investing in B2B financing. So in the case of default, what will funding society do?
So in addition to doing the credit assessment and due diligence and disbursement of the financing to SMEs, right, funding societies also helps to manage the repayments as well as the monitoring and the collections of the repayments from SMEs. So in the event that the SMEs is late in their repayments, then funding societies will go to the SME to understand why there's been a late repayment, right? If it's because of financial distress, genuine financial distress, then we work out a repayment or reschedule financing obligations timelines.
The means for maybe 6 months,
yep.
Reschedule to 12 months. How about the interest?
Yep. So even the interest, that will be negotiated with the SME, right? And obviously with approval from the investor.
Okay.
Right? But in the event that the SME is just uncooperative in terms of making repayments, so they just choose not to repay, right? And in that situation, we can actually pursue collection efforts, right? So that one we can either do in-house or outsource a third-party collection agency, right? Worst case scenario, we can actually take litigation action against the SME, against the company as well as directors, because we do take personal guarantees.
Also, the director will be the one, be the guarantor for the...
Yes,
the
correct.
Sinubahat also the same?
Yes,
the correct. Director will be the vendor.
Yes.
Okay, good. So to minimize the default risk, due diligence is an important factor. So how do funding society access the company?
So in terms of minimum eligibility, SMEs that are 1 year in operations or has 1 million in revenue, right, can apply. Right? They also need to be clear such that they do not have any active litigation or bankruptcy against them. Right. In terms of the type of companies that can apply, not just the Lambrahats, but also proprietorships and partnerships can apply as well. Right. So those are criteria when it comes to applying for financing.
This is the first level of filter.
Yes, correct.
Okay, then put on.
Yeah. So on second layer of filter, once it passed all those criteria, is basically we look at the financial statements. So from the financial statements, we look at basically the business model. So what is the revenue size? What is the gross profit? What is the different sales administrative costs and so forth, right? So that helps us to assess the business case or business model of the SME. We also look at basically, are they receiving funds from their customers on time and are they paying their suppliers on time, right? So that might be indicate signs of whether the company's cash flow is healthy or deteriorating. In addition to financial statements, we also look at bank statements. So bank statements would give us a truer picture in terms of the inflows and outflows, cash inflows and cash outflows of the business. Finally, we also look at the CTOS and CCRIS reports of both the directors, shareholders, as well as the company itself. So that will tell us whether this director or the company has been making their repayments on the other financing that they have on time or have they been late. As well as how many applications that have been put in for financing, so on and so forth. So that will, those all those different your parameters.
Big picture of how the repayment ability of the company.
Yes, correct. So that gives us a sort of holistic picture of how the SME is performing and whether they are able to repay the financing or not.
Okay, okay.
Yeah.
That's it. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
No worries.
Okay.
希望这个有回答到你们的问题，谢谢大家看完这个 video， 喜欢的话就 like， 然后也分享去给你的朋友知道。想要看到更多类似的 video，就去 like 我的 page， 还有 subscribe 我的 YouTube channel， 谢谢大家。